Hello friends, today I arrived in Northern Ireland and I am in the city of Belfast. This is the hometown of the Titanic and we are going to visit into Queen's Belfast, the International Center at Queen's University of Belfast, and we'll find out what they teach here. Of course, we'll see how students live or what the residences look like. There is going to be a lot of exciting and interesting things. I'll give you some spoilers. We'll visit the locations where Game of Thrones was filmed and we'll also visit the Giant's Trail. What is that? You'll see soon. Can you imagine having rooms like this in a computer engineering building for just like a regular meetings? Well, check this out, so cool and stylish. This is a room where students can get together, the arcade machines here, a lot of stuffs hanging on the walls. I must say it's a really nice lobby. It takes 4 years to learn computer science here, and 1 year of that is necessarily is a placement, which is when you do something in a company of some sort, learn by working. Cool, very cool. By the way, they showed me one of the classrooms where they use a Lego to have students do different projects on how computers relate to different engineering things. They show me different halls. Each room has a different design and style. And for example, this room over here was designed by a company, and a big thing is that companies invest in the university in order to collaborate with it and then employ graduate students. I was also told about the previous room where everything was painted in bright colors. The furniture there was brought all the way from Italy. Another room, unlike any previous one, to be more specific, is a classroom. Look, I just want to show you what the classrooms are like. I mean, it's not just tables and desks. Here are some desks where students can sit in groups. The blackboard covers the entire wall. And see, students can sit and relax in these zones here. There are couches, there is an electronic whiteboard, a TV, a screen, I don't know how many inches, but it's not small. World-famous Titanic was built right here in Belfast, the capital of Northern Ireland. Now the city even has what's called the Titanic Quarter, which is a massive reconstruction of the waterfront. In 2012, it was 100 years since the Titanic sailed from the port in Belfast. It's now one of the largest ports here. It would probably take more than 1 hour to walk around it, and it's a really huge place in terms of square footage. There are plans to build residential houses and parks here by 2030. The project is already in place, yeah, and everything is already on the map, and there will be about 30,000 people living here. It includes historic maritime landmarks, movie studios, educational institutions, apartment buildings, and of course the Titanic Memorial Museum. It tells the story of the Titanic, which was sailed from this city and which sank on its maiden voyage in 1912. From 19,000 to 1913, 247 ships were built here. At that time, it was the world record. No place in the world built more than here in Belfast. And this is the central building of Queen's University. We look at the signs and the map. To understand the size of the university, you can see where and what is located. Here I see 39 buildings on the map. 39. Just to show you the scale of the university. And now I'm in the architectural building. The architecture here is at very high level, which is important. Each student has their own desk during the course of the year. So you have your desk as an office. It's a completely open building, an open space. There are no separate offices. Every student here can see what the others are doing. And it affects the ability to collaborate or work together between students. I think that's awesome. It's not a separate classroom where things change, students change. It's a whole workspace here. This is the university building that used to be the largest brick building in all of Europe. And only a few years ago it was surpassed by another building, I don't know exactly which one. Anyway, it's a huge building that's easy to get lost in. There are several departments here now, including engineering. The next department is the Department of Finance. Now I am in an office that is fully sponsored by a company. This is another thing about Queen's University, and company FinTrue sponsors the finance department. Students also have the opportunity to work for that company afterward. For example, here on boards are students who have been hired after successfully completing the program. Queen's University is in the 10th place in the UK in terms of students' employment. Of course, the graduates then go to different companies in different fields in different parts of the world, from Hong Kong to the United States. If you're considering studying law, Queen's Law School is one of the top 10 in the United Kingdom. That's where we are in the law building. If you're going to visit Belfast, you have to go here right away and spend some time. We had super weather on the way, the sun was shining, and now you see, on the video that the sun is going down, it's starting to drizzle a little bit. The Queen's University Library recently won an international award for architecture. Here in the library, there's a door that was filmed in the Chronicles of Narnia, where they just run through this door. And that door now leads to this really cool room, which is completely stylized for the Chronicles of Narnia. Even here on the table is a map of these islands. Game of Thrones, of course, was filmed in different locations, and we came to another one. This is where one of the scenes was filmed. And only two fragments made it into an episode. I don't know exactly which one, you can look it up and you may find it. They are 20 seconds long. Second day of my stay here, and today we're looking at the residences where the students live. Right now we're on campus, and that's the area with different buildings where the students live, and this is what it all looks like. It's like a small town. This is one of the newest buildings, then all the way across the campus there are many different houses. This is the common room in one of the residences. It has everything here. Look, different desks with USB chargers, different computer chargers, bars, tools right here. The bar is now closed for anti-COVID reasons, of course. There are different areas. Pool. There are arcade machines, table tennis. There is an area for personal training, of course. Just awesome. The capacity of this whole campus is amazing. It's not really the only one here. It's just one of the biggest campuses of the university. There are additional residences closer to the city center. But Belfast itself is small and everything is within walking distance. The capacity of all the residences is about 3,000 people. All the rooms here are for one person. We'll take a look at them with you. I was told that most of the rooms here are 90% occupied, and I was shown one empty room. It's a typical student's room. Here we got a small bed, a desk. By the way, the desk is 2 meters wide. Shelves, closet, the bathroom, a shower is basically standard, like all bathrooms. Of course, all this will be decorated when students come here. Each student immediately gets this kit with a SIM card, a flash drive, with basic materials and various instructions. I was told that there are even special residences where families live. Students who have a family can study and live well with their families. There is also a room in the residence for individual study. In addition to having your own room, and many people think a room is everything you get. The residences also have a separate room, so with the computers where you can come and study in a quiet environment if you don't want to be in the room all the time. And now we are in the medical center. Here, the whole medical center imitates everything that happens in a real hospital. Here we see mannequins. This is a very expensive thing. I mean, the price can go up to the cost of a car. There are cameras built in when students do something. It's all recorded and then shown on the screens. Students watch, checking what they did wrong, what they did right. There are also microphones, which means conversations are also recorded. This is a simulation center for a real-life conditions in which future doctors and nurses will be put. Real actors might also be employed here to simulate. Yeah, simulate. And there is another brand new biological center. Right off the bat, I want to point out that this is where the most stylish subject is studied. It takes fourth place in the whole of the UK. It is food nutrition, which is the study of nutrition. Healthy eating is becoming very, very popular right now. You understand why? That's what this center specializes in. There are life sciences and even marine biology. One of the centers here in direct contact with the lake and the sea. If you are interested in biology, biomedical sciences, and medicine, Belfast is a great choice for that.